Is this the future of urban freight transport? The Volta Zero truck promises clean and above all safe deliveries. But why does it look like a bus? We're going to find out.
Volta is a Swedish startup that is looking to challenge the big ones in the truck segment, and now we're going to check out what they have to offer.
Volta says it's made the world's first purpose-built full-electric 16-ton truck designed specifically for goods distribution in urban environments. The vehicle has been built from the ground up to take advantages of electric power technology on busy, cramped streets.
Since the drivetrain of this truck is at the rear axle, the front axle has more space to move, and thus the complete vehicle is way nimbler than, for example, a diesel truck.
Ditching the diesel combustion engine for a battery electric drivetrain allows for even more revolutionary design hacks.
If you stand in front of it, it kind of looks like a bus, but if you stand side it, you see it's basically not a bus.
The design inspiration from a bus and a coach is deliberate, because if you think about it, that vehicle is designed to operate in city centres safely. Yeah. So if I take Transport for London statistics, because that's the one I have in my head, 4% of road miles in London are travelled by trucks. Mm. 26% of pedestrian fatalities and 78% of cyclist deaths in London are attributable to trucks. The cab is all about maximising driver visibility and the driver's view of what they're driving around, whether that's with their eyes or through the cameras, assisting them around a 360-degree view of the vehicle so that we maximise the safety of a truck this size driving through city centre streets.
What we see right now is the driver sitting in the centre, which is rather unusual.
Yes, yeah. And if you think about it, everybody has a left and a right-hand drive. But if you're the driver of that vehicle, you have to make a judgment where that far side is, and that's always going to be a judgment. Whereas if you're sitting in the center, you're putting the human at the literally in the center of everything, but they have exactly the same width either side to make the judgment when they're driving through a narrow street. It's also the best position for visibility. So our driver has 220 degrees of direct visibility, so that they have a really good view of everything going on around them. Our driver doesn't have to climb in and out of a cab that's up here somewhere. Yeah. They can literally, as you see, walk straight in.
Yeah.
But every time they get in and out, they get in and out always onto the sidewalk, onto the pavement. The driver of a left or a right-hand drive vehicle always gets out into the traffic. So our driver is a lot safer. We have sliding doors rather than swinging doors. Yeah. So whenever the driver does get out, they're not opening their door into the pathway of cyclists coming past.
Yeah.
So we have keep the vehicle width to an absolute minimum. So we've done absolutely everything we can for the safe operation of a vehicle this size in city centers.
This is not a long haul truck, but it can carry 8 tons of cargo at up to 90 kilometers per hour, a fair distance.
So we have a range of 150 or 200 kilometers of range, and a customer can specify either 2 battery packs or 3 battery packs. If they have a refrigerated cargo box, it will always get specified with the 3rd battery pack, because our refrigerated operation is running straight from the battery as well.
All Volta Zero models offer some 38 cubic meters of load space.
In 2021, Germany had more than 3.5 million registered trucks on its road. Now, do you want to guess how many of these had an alternative drivetrain? Not even 80,000. So I think a truck like this has the potential to become a huge success, but not only in Germany.
The combination of zero emissions and increased road safety could be very attractive to logistics firms. The European rollout for the 16-ton Volta Zero will begin in 2023, and the company says it's also planning 7.5 and 12-ton Volta Zero variants.
That's all for now. Keep on trucking and join us for more automotive adventures on the next episode of REV.